It's us, me and McKenna. It's Thursday morning and it's Brooklyn Live because we are in Brooklyn and I have with me, come on up here, young lady, Fizzy Izzy.
Good morning.
I like the way it's like, good morning. Oh, I got to do it. Do we go in the right way? Good morning.
Good morning.
Right, McKenna's moving a little bit, eh? So we're going to talk about the colour because Isabel and Ilaria were getting into this. But before we talk about the colour, why don't we introduce to Michaela? Is that right? McKenna?
McKenna.
McKenna. Where are you from, McKenna?
I'm from Queens.
Queens. Queens in the house.
Queens in the house.
And what do you do for a living? Do you work?
I'm actually not working right now, but I'm going to school.
What are you going to school for?
I'm going to school for multimedia design.
Wow. Super. What's multimedia design? It sounds like a lot, doesn't it?
Yeah.
MMD. Yeah, what is that?
It's like graphic design, just doing design on different platforms. So
okay,
like,
good. Awesome. Good. Now we know who to go to if we need some work done. Yeah. What are we going to do with your hair? Looks like you're feeling blue today. What are we going to do? You have some inspiration to show us?
Yes, I do.
All right, let's have a look.
Good morning,
okay.
Lisa Torres.
Let's have a look. Cal, can you zoom in on this picture? There you go. So, there she is. Look at that. So, this is her inspiration. So, we've got super short on the sides. There's definitely some hair there, but it's slicked back. What about length for you? Are you like that length? Do you mind if you go a little shorter, or do you want to keep it the length that it already is? You tell me.
I don't mind if you want to go a little shorter.
Don't mind.
Whatever you think is convenient.
All right, Izzy, I'm getting in. So while I get my sections, Isabel, why don't you tell us what you and Ilario did right here?
Okay, so...
Because you really went to town here, didn't you?
We did. We kind of just went for it, yeah. Yesterday, myself and Ilario, who's our new talent here at Arrojo Williamsburg, we decided we wanted to do something nice and fresh and new for the colour for McKenna. So she had about an inch of root, and she already had like a navy blue on the ends. So we pre-lightened the roots with Studio 9 and 6%. We did it in 4 quads and let each one develop 45 minutes. And then we had a look at the Pulp Riot selection of color we had, and decided to go for the aquatic and some of the navy blue also from the other L'Oreal. Color, but yeah, we kind of mixed the two together to make it quite deep and dark, and still had that little bit of green to it as well, which we thought was really cool. Yeah, and we went with it really, saw how much it lifted and dropped it back down a little bit to get some nice coverage.
You feel good about that, do you?
I do actually. Yeah,
you had a lot of fun, didn't you? Hey?
We had a lot of fun. Yeah.
Okay, let's just have a look at this one section. We just put one section. McKenna, you've got a lot of hair.
Yeah,
she's got enough hair for four.
She has.
Yeah?
Yes.
So we've taken like a nice horseshoe-esque kind of section, taking it all the way into just a little bit of the nape, and we're going to cut all this off right now. So let's just take this down completely.
Exactly.
And we're actually over, just kind of right at the round of the head. So we're going to do something like this on both sides, but they don't have to be the same. So the first thing I'm doing is establishing the first line, then I'll quickly cut it, then we'll scissor over comb. So we will be using the razor, but right now for this we have to use the scissor. And right above us, you can see from right above, you can see how I'm just working this section. Where the section is where I cut in my fingers first. And also because she's had her hair heavily lifted, this swells the hair. So the hair swells out as it kind of gets lifted. So I've really got to be kind of very definitive here as I go through this makeover, which I think will be a lot of fun. She's got great bone structure, beautiful girl. And all we got to do now is make her look stronger and a little edgier. So I'm following that right the way in with my fingertips. Once you've done that, that establishes kind of the top line, We can just scoop this out because this is all gonna go short.
Exciting. We have good morning from Lisa Torres.
Hi Lisa, how are you? Thanks for joining us. We have people. Isabel, are you working today, young Izzy?
I am. Yes, I'll be here in Williamsburg today.
Wow, she can see that, can't you? Eh? She can see that.
Oh boy.
Oh boy.
We got it on the big screens here.
Yeah, so right now what I'll do is I'll just go in there with the wide teeth of my comb just to take this out completely. And then we'll go to the smaller side of my comb. Your comb is important. You know, we talk about tools of the trade. Very important to get the right tools of the trade. So this is actually my razor comb. But I'm working using the razor comb first because it's got wide teeth and it means I can really get into the hair because the hair is super dense. So you kind of shape it down first. You don't want to spend too much time on this because I can spend more time on this later. When you're creating something as such, you got to make sure that you don't just, I don't want to focus too much on one piece. I got to get the overall shaping. As I get the overall shaping, then I will start to refine. So I've just rotated the comb around. And now I'm just going in with the finer teeth, which enables me to get a little shorter and a little cleaner. Behind the ear, be very careful. When you're working scissor over comb, you should notice it's just my thumb that moves. So as I work through, just the thumb's moving up and down. If I spin around, you'll see. So you keep everything very steady and just the thumb. And in here, not taking too much out. Not taking too much out into the nape, just a slither. You can put your head up, you look like you're strained there. So just take that in just a little. And then that is kind of a bit of our side done.
Amazing.
And then what we're going to do is we're going to go to the other side and we're going to do more. I will come back to this. The one thing you want to be careful of is don't build up too much weight right at the top. You don't want to build the weight up because that's going to not let the hair on top of it sit properly. Now, I can't tell you how thick a hair is, but imagine the thickest hair you've ever seen. It's kind of like where we're at with the thickest of hair. Isn't that right?
That's very right, yeah.
That's right.
It took me a few hours, I'm not going to lie, to get the colour done.
Did it? How long was you here for?
Probably about 4 or 5 hours.
Yeah.
Okay, so, you know, as you comb the hair around, it's going to help you to see kind of your inspiration. This side, I'm not going to go as high. I'm going to go a little lower on this side.
Awesome. We have good morning all. Love the hair color. I have teal hair too from Donna DiLapo.
There you go. You see that? Now you're a colorist, is he? This is the color queen. I'm going to take this side. So again, this is a great comb for putting in the section. I spin it just a little. I think I'll spin around to number 3, might be a good angle. And you can see, I've got these great clips that are super strong. These are the Arrojo clips. I like them because they're strong for strong hair. I just don't like this little piece here. This is the temple area. The temple areas always like change the way the hair looks, so really focus in on the temple. Because she has got such dense hair, her hairline is super close to her eyebrows. Okay, that's very typical, so she's very close right in here. So I want to take that in nice and tight, because that's going to create a little bit more space for the hair to move. Let's get that just a smidgen cleaner. It's really important that your sections are done really well. You get one chance to cut it like this, one chance. So now we're going to do exactly the same. You can see there's the section, slightly lower and slightly deeper, but not much, like maybe a quarter more of an inch deeper into the nape line. So again, just take your section right on that line, and let's just take this all the way out. So we're going straight to the best bit, really, you know? Slim the sides down, it's going to reduce the hair a lot, and then we're going to pick up the razor and we're going to cut the rest of it. We're going to take and create more shape. We're taking her from looking, you know, kind of nice but quite normal. I know it's blue, but it's still very normal, and we're just edging the hair a lot. It's going to change the overall appearance of McKenna.
Awesome. Be super versatile as well.
It is?
Yeah.
What's going to be versatile about it? She's got both sides shaved.
She can move the top around.
Oh, there you go. But we are going to show that it is quite versatile,
yeah,
for sure.
Cool.
So we know it's New York. It's December the 10th. We know that, you know, all of our friends in California, you know, they've been told to not work. One of the things that I'm really focusing in on right now is what are we going to do? And next year, one of the things that is going to be on my agenda is to create a hairdressing organization here for New York. There's a gentleman by the name of, I think it's Fred Jones, out in California, and he's part of the Beauty Federation there, which has done a great job of helping salons kind of fight back and push back to stay open, support salons. We don't really have much of a voice. And in California, some people have been closed down 3 times. It's how disgraceful, realistically, that you can't work. I just find it to be abhorrent. So next year, one of the things that I'm going to focus on is the development. And under Fred's advice, he said if there's a beauty association in each state across America, that is the best way to advocate for hair salons and for people in the beauty business. So watch this space, because I'm very committed to making sure that we do that. Because I'm sick to death of being told I can't do what I do, and I can't do the job that I need to do. So that's something that I'm very focused on, and I'm gonna drive that a lot more in the coming months. We actually have a great name for our association, and I'll be sharing that with you again as we get closer to pulling that together. It'll be a New York based, as a New York State based association, and I encourage people across America in different states to do exactly the same thing. So just working around the hairline and just cleaning this up, taking it really super tight. We're going to do it, we're going to do it, and we're going to go for it. You get one chance to do it, so this is the chance. Now, Isabel's here, so if you do have any questions for us, you can certainly interact with us. We're here in our Williamsburg location, which is where we set up our studio. We had our holiday Happy Mondays, which was this past Monday. And we've put our next Happy Mondays on the calendar, which will be January the 10th, I believe. It'll be the second Monday in December. I mean January. My brain's fried today. Pickled! I gotta stop. Did you put vodka in my coffee, Isabel?
Absolutely.
Oh, I thought so. Absolute as well.
Absolute. We have some good mornings from Maritza Garcia Hernandez. Angela Gonzalez says, Buenos dias, Nick.
Oh, nice.
Crystal Henderson says good morning, and Alex Lonu says good morning, gang.
That's Alex from Chicago. What do you call him? Ianu. You call him Lonu.
Luanu.
He's laughing right now.
My apologies, Alex.
He's laughing at you right now in Chicago. So this is kind of like got both sides taken care of. The nice thing is with these virus shields that we use when it's just me and one person on the platform, because obviously we want to keep everybody safe, But the nice thing is you get to see the bone structure of the client. And you can get the inspiration, because when you're doing hair, the inspiration always comes from the client's features, the client's face, the client's image. You know, remember, we're in the beauty business here. So we want to make people look more beautiful. That's our overall goal. It is very important that you just get your comb right in the right direction so that you can take this hair nice and clean. Practice your scissor over comb. I know a lot of people like to do it with clippers, but you know where we learn in Sassoons in the 80s, we were not allowed to use clippers at all. Remember that, Isabel?
I do remember that, yes.
Scissor only. Okay, done. Both sides done. Now the interesting thing is going to be to see how this hair is actually going to, how it's going to cut with a razor. And you've got to do, because we've taken this off, we're going to see what we're going to create. So she already has a pre-existing bangs. She's got, as I keep saying, a ton of hair. So let's have a look and see what we can, just look at the hair and see as we comb it through, because I've got to kind of get into this. I'm going to need some healing oil, which is one of our hair products. And I love the healing oil because it's going to give me more slip, and it's also going to help compress the hair as the hair flattens. Because when you lift the hair like this, the hair becomes fatter. It kind of swells. So I'm going to focus now purely on the front. So I'm looking at my sectioning and I'm staying with the wide teeth of the comb. I use the black comb because I think you might get some transfer anyway. So I've got this comb comes in black and white. So let's focus on this. This will be kind of our front section. Then we'll connect the back in. So if you go to the top, Carl, please. You can see we've really taken kind of like a real strong section right here. You got to kind of make simplification of the cut. So let's focus, and I'm going to put a little bit of the healing oil, which is a heat protector, as well as this is the product, healing oil. It's a heat protector and it's a glossing spray. Now I've got my razor. I'm going to clip this back. So I'll take a section, I'm going to clip it out. Bang, bang, bang. Focus on the front and the back will follow. Take a central section. Hair's dried out a little here. So, you know, you'll see me use Hydro Mist a lot if you watch me. Again, using products during the service is a great thing because, you know, you need products to make it look great. So first section, quite a healthy section. She recently had a bangs cut. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to see how this blade can thin out and just add a little bit more texture. Fine teeth of the comb. I'm using what I call my tipping technique just to soften out some of the soften out the bangs. Next section. Now we just, because the bangs are already cut, I'm really working more on texture. I'm going to extend the shape deeper into the back. You'll see that. And here I'm taking a little bit of length out too. Through here. Working this down. This is an open stroke with the blade. And I comb with the wide teeth so I can see the shape actually build. You're going to have used super high tension. The high tension is very important for you to get the blade to glide through the hair. And then I'm dropping this down so it's longer to the cheekbone. So it extends down and around. This is going to expose kind of the shortness underneath, which is going to like look magic. I mean, she's going to look superb. And that's the power of a great haircut, a great hair color, you know? Now it's the holidays, but if you're in New York City, I can tell you what it's like. You know, even though the salons are open, there's a lot of, you know, the environment is a lot of people are not leaving their houses. So it's very, very quiet. And in the city here, they're talking about closing the indoor dining this week. So it's going to be a long, dark winter for all of us, which is going to be a shame, isn't it?
It really is, yeah.
But I hear there's a great place uptown that you go to, Isabel, for like a birthday brunch. What's it called? What's it called?
It's called Brazia.
It's called Brazia. What is it, a bra? Is it a Brazia? You go to Brazia and
it's
what
happens? It genuinely looked like something very desolate before you walked in.
And this is a restaurant?
When you get in there, it's pretty happening.
Did you go to celebrate somebody's birthday and it was happening in the Brazil?
We did. Yeah. We did, yeah. Noelle, who also works here, she turned 24, so we had a little birthday bottomless brunch.
A bottomless brunch. What do you think to that, Cal? A bottomless brunch at the Brazil. Yeah. Did you have a good time?
It was wild.
And it's, where is it?
It's in Inwood.
Inwood?
Yeah, so it's like really North Manhattan, I guess.
You sounded very American then. Really North Manhattan, always. Okay, so you can see what we're doing here. Kind of filling this through, making a more definitive kind of image of the shape. It's all about the bone structure. You know, you've got to look and kind of, with this shortness through here, it completely changes the way that she looks. Yeah, just completely changes the way she looks. But I'm marrying it to this line. Then I'm going to drop this line down. So when you are doing your haircuts and you've got a lot of hair to deal with, you know, try and think about keeping it as simplistic as possible. You don't want to overcomplicate what you're doing. So it's like three steps here. Step one was the sides. Step two is the top. And step three is the back. And that's all I need to focus on. If I overcomplicate it, it's going to be, you know, I'll lose myself. When I say lose yourself, you just end up getting focused on areas that maybe are not important. So that's a little hydro mist. And then a little healing oil. You still breathing? Yeah? She's still breathing. That's good. She's got a support network here to help her. We've got 25 friends here in the back. There to carry her off in case we need to. So again, I'm just not gonna take this shorter. I'm just peeling the top surface just away. Just to add, it's a little wavy too, which is very typical. Where are you, where's your ethnicity from?
I'm Filipino.
Filipino. Mm-hmm. So it's thick Filipino hair, that's for sure. Yes. And it's got a little curl to it, but maybe that curl's been enhanced as well by the lightener.
Yeah,
because when you lighten this kind of hair and make it so light so you can get the deposit of the color, it can take a lot out of the hair and it changes the texture. So notice how it's just my fingers moving, just my fingers, not my wrist. Notice I'm trying to comb it to have a look at it, keeping it as soft as possible. If I see that it's too dense, then I go in and just lighten it with the tip of the blade. And we're combing all these sections forward and dropping it down. Now remember the image she's shown us, the model who was wearing that great look, pushed her hair away. So we're gonna be pushing this hair around and showing you how it looks different as you move it around. But the razor here is just such a critical tool because it helps to soften out the hair. And it's also important to comb it with the wide teeth of the comb so you can see how the hair wants to live. Because when you comb it with the fine teeth, you're kind of locking it down. When you comb it with the wide teeth, you're allowing it to live a little. So you always comb with the fine to get nice tension as we come in right here and just move that down and around. And then we'll follow this line through.
Awesome. We have a question about the razor.
Yes.
How much do they retail at?
Okay, so this is the handcrafted wood razor, and you just missed out on the sale because we had a 25% off sale, but they're $2.99, and there's about seven different styles of wood. This one, we got a wenge, which is like a dark wood. We've got bleach wenge, which is a light wood, yellow wood, olive wood. We've got a lot of different razor textures, and they're all available on arrojopro.com. And someone might put a link up there so that you can actually see. Wow, she's changed. McKenna's going through a change here.
It's really cool.
And now this is just the tip, just to soften out. So we're focused on all the good bits, yeah? That's what we're doing, focusing on the good bits to begin. The front, and then after this, it's a question of just blending the sides in. Then we'll smooth it out, we'll dry it, and we'll show you how we dry it, and then we're probably gonna use an iron to flatten and press the hair, which is nice, so that's gonna give the hair some sheen, because today's gonna be the impact day, high impact day today. When you do hair a long time, you never forget the impact that you have. As a stylist, that's very important. Sometimes you can kind of let that slip you by because we've been doing it for such a long time. Final section, and then we drop the back, and the back's going to really fill it out. So this is the flat plane of the blade there, and then I'm going to go with a second run with the tip of the blade. We call that tipping. We have a razor class coming up next year. If you want to come and learn with me, we've got quite a few different offerings that we're going to be launching. We're going to have a razor class, a one-dayer. We're going to have a virtual one-day razor class. And then I'm going to have some hands-on classes here too. So we got the best of everything. Let's just shake all that away. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Right, so let's clip this out, unclip it, and as we drop this in, now what we're going to do is we're going to kind of come through, and I'm not going to blend it, I'm going to kind of texture it, so not really blending, so I'm not going to connect, I don't really want to connect, I just want to kind of take out some of the density. I'm going to push my blade as strongly as I can through the hair, so what I'm not saying is I'm not going to connect it in here. It's going to look, I don't think that's going to be as nice. Keep it a little bit looser so it's not connected, but once we thin it, it's going to feel good. Can you hold that for me, sweet? Thanks. Yeah, we can chill. There you go. Yeah, well, maybe not there. We'll put it there. It's a family show. We'll stick it right there. There you go. It's too early on a Thursday.
Good morning.
Good morning, everybody. Hello. So right here, looking through the hair, just tipping in.
We have some people watching from the UK. Rachel Bishop, good morning. Well, good afternoon.
English people?
English people!
Whoa, I like that. When are you going back to England next, Isabel?
I don't know, we'll see.
Will they let you back in?
Hopefully the spring.
Hopefully the spring. So again, I'm not connecting in here. I'm combing the hair out, and I'm literally just working about 2 inches away from the ends of the hair. I'm looking through the hair. I want to create kind of, always think of your haircuts as, well-tailored. So I want to kind of well-tailor the shape. When I talk about well-tailoring the shape, what that means is just kind of get the smoothness and the flow all the way in. So what's American hairdressing like compared to British hairdressing?
It's good, it's fun, it's different.
It is?
We've got a lot more hair to work with in the US.
Lot more hair, isn't it?
Yes, definitely.
And how's your razor cutting become?
I feel like pretty confident with it now. It's obviously only been a couple of years nearly, but yeah, it's coming along nicely, and I'm really, really enjoying working with the razor, creating different shapes and sculpture, and yeah, it's really opened my eyes to learn something brand new.
Did you find it different from working at Sassoon's with SZA?
Absolutely, yeah. It's a whole different, form and function, isn't it?
It's a different approach, isn't it?
Yeah, a different approach. But it really opens up a lot of doors, I feel like.
Now, the sheer density of this hair is super, super dense. So really want to kind of create as much freedom and movement in this hair as possible. I mean, when I get into the back here, she's got the amount of hair for four people. So she's lucky. We're only going to charge her for three, so that'll be good. Yeah.
Kelly Stobart just joined. Good morning, Kelly.
Oh, Kelly, all the way from Chicago. Another Chicago.
Chicago.
Hey, Kelly, how are you? Now, don't lose patience in here. Don't lose patience. You've really got to get the balance right. And, you know, it's not challenging hair. It's just uber dense. And we want to make it, like, silky. That's what we want to do. We want to make it, like, silk. So you want to kind of get that softness in there. All right, I've cut all the way to one side. You can see that, cut all the way to one side. Now let's attack this side. I'll take my little thing from you over here. Use your mirror, always looking in your mirror to make sure you can see what you're creating. Hydro Mist is going to add that little bit of slip, moisture to the hair. And don't over wet the hair if you don't need to. So what that means is once you've kind of got your shape moving in, don't wet it anymore. You want to see the hair dry. You want to allow it to dry so that you can see what it's saying to you. And the hair does talk. So right here, very precise. Just trying to soften and create space so that we can get more slip to the hair. When the hair is lightened so much like this as well, sometimes you get a stronger bite when the hair dries out a little. Wide teeth of the comb. If I didn't have this wide teeth comb right at the front, it would be very hard for me to get sections. So again, just the point of the tip of the blade, we call this tipping. Now, if you are in England and you want to learn razor cutting, maybe you can join me for my introduction to razor. It's going to be a virtual class. It's also going to be a hands-on class. We have this studio set up here that we can actually, through Zoom, we can actually see you work and we can train you and we can connect and communicate. Some of the classes have not been put on the website yet because, we've not had the time. Because we've really been, you know, obviously through a lot this year, readdressing the fallout from this coronavirus, which we're obviously still in. But we will be putting up some of our digital classes in the coming weeks, and that's something that we'll be working on today. So it doesn't matter where you are, I know I can teach you razoring if you want to learn razor cutting. And razor cutting creates space. So when you create space, the hair moves in a better way. Elevate this hair up. Look through the density of the hair and just with the tip of the blade, just melt that away. Very fluid, very consistent. You'll notice it's just the motion in the fingertips. There is nothing else working apart from the fingers. This the thumb and the pointer finger. The wrist is not in action, it's not engaged at all. So it's just very meticulous. Is it feeling lighter?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's getting cold.
It's getting a bit cold. I think you'll be okay. Yeah, I think you'll be okay. Yeah, if you've got thin hair like me, then I'll be cold, but you got thick hair, so you got like a rug on the top. It keeps all the heat in. Insulation.
Good morning, Nick, from Joseph's Hair Salon in Strongsville, Ohio.
Yeah, so you can see us every Thursday, Brooklyn Live. We've been doing this for the past 4 years. just take a chance to, you know, do some education, promote what we're about as a brand, as a business. So you can always find us here on Facebook. And if you don't get to see it, you can always watch it because it stays virtually in the environment. Always on my Facebook page. Join me on Tuesday night for Nick at 9. Hope to have a good session. It's been a few weeks since we had a Nick at 9, but I think it's time for a Nick at 9, which will be on my Instagram. And that's very much an informal chat. We usually have a few guests to connect so we can share, you know, our ideas, thoughts, concepts, and, you know, challenges. Comb it with the white teeth and let your hand kind of run through it so you can feel how the hair, how the density of the hair is. So you'll see as a fast movement with the blade, but I'm looking through the hair. I want to keep the integrity in the hair. I'm looking through the hair and I'm looking for like an even fade. So what I mean by that, I mean that I want it to fade away. So I want the ends to kind of taper. I'm looking for density and lightness. As I come through here, I'm looking for that softness and consistency. So I don't want to gouge into it. It's just the tip of the blade. I'll be going back to my Soho location straight after. I've got clients today. So it's a good day in the salon. I typically do clients every day when I'm at work. Yeah, it's important for me to be on the shop floor. New York has lost a lot of inhabitants. A lot of people have left because of the pandemic and also, you know, because of the crime. The crime is spiking right now. And I think we might be spiking for a while to come. We're all anxiously waiting to see what they do in reference to shutdowns. So we'll find out what it goes like. How did you enjoy the shutdown, Isabel? We were closed for what, for 3.5 months?
3.5 months, yeah.
Yeah.
I've never had that amount of time off work before.
Did you go to that brunch place every day?
A what?
Did you go to the brasier every day?
Went to my local brasier. No, it was a strange time, to be honest. But
terrible time, eh?
Yeah.
See what happens.
I'm happy to still be coming to work every day. It's nice.
Yeah, it's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
So we're getting close now to power drying, and then I'm going to smooth it. Again, you know, one of the things that I've learned over the years is I hate things to go slow. I train quick. I work fast. You know, some people it's not fast, but for me it's fast. And it's important. It keeps your energy. Whoa, who is she? She's got a big screen right here, she can see.
It looks awesome.
All right, so now we've got the healing oil. I'm gonna put a little bit more healing oil in. Do you wanna get me that iron plugged in?
Yes.
So that's a glossing spray. I'll need my dryer. Let's power dry it. Now you can see how dense this hair is. This is my new blow dryer. It's the Arrojo Ionic. I turn the Ionic switch on. It's going to help to defrizz it and smooth out the hair. So I'm just lifting the hair so I can get all the moisture out. Keep your hand in so you don't burn the, don't make the client too hot. But we need to get the hair bone dry, because if the hair is bone dry, then I can smooth it with the iron. So working my fingers now, it's really, you know, it's fat hair. So you got to really work it through. The healing oil is also a heat protector. That's going to help to protect Just loosen that up as much as possible. Let's get this hair dry. Hangs onto the moisture. But we can see how it looks messy and loose. You can see that even though we've taken a lot of hair, she's still got a lot of hair.
It just keeps growing.
And it's important when you're drying like this, you can look at the style and look for things that you like. Because, you know, good haircuts, good hairstyles are movable. Rotate my hand. Shake it through. You can see the texture. Are you happy with your handiwork? Do you think Alara will be happy, Isabel?
I think he'll be very happy. He's really excited to get some pictures today, actually.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Where is he then? Is he here? He's excited to get some pictures. Where the heck is he?
He turned up!
Is he there?
No.
No. Exactly. Alario.
Let's FaceTime him.
Sorry?
FaceTime him in. He'd be like,
is he watching? If he's watching, say hello. That's what we'll do. See whether he's actually watching.
Yeah, if you're watching Alario, let us know.
We have a staff meeting tomorrow. You know about that?
I do, yeah.
Good.
We'll be in Soho tomorrow morning.
Yeah, we'll have a staff meeting. Now the iron's on, is it? Did you turn it on?
The iron's on, ready to go, yeah.
370. Let's get it at 370, temperature-wise. Nice look. I like that. The soft, flowy hair.
Yeah, it's beautiful hair, isn't it? It's got strong hair.
Strong.
Yeah. Got a few of the bricks watching today.
Yeah?
I think that'll be great to do the virtual classes for razor in itself.
Yeah, do they razor much in England, Isabel, that you know of?
Awesome
to get some people to tune into that. Okay. Still wet. You see? Still wet in areas. just keeps on getting wetter. There you go. Alright, now enough of that. Now let's go in with again. I'm just going to put a little bit of healing oil into the hair, which I think will be, you can't put too much into this hair. It's gonna soak it right up. Now we'll take that Isatec iron, 370. I got my clips. Let's start in the back. This will take a little minute, but we gotta do it. Chin down for me, sweetheart, thanks. So you can take your clip, section that hair away. The clips are nice and strong. And you know, we've not finished cutting yet, but we're close. I'm just gonna move that iron straight the way through. And that's gonna press that hair nice and flat. Next section. So it's gonna change the texture. Love the clips. Clips are available on Arrojo Pro. All of our tools are available on arrojopro.com. So if you're interested in razors, clips, scissors, we have a really nice, amazing tool roll and a tool bag that are coming out in January, which we've just developed. So We have a cosmetology school here in New York, and it's more than a cosmo school. I keep calling it a cosmo school because that's how it started, but right now we have a barbering program, and we also have our aesthetics program. So it's more than cosmetology. And that's in my Soho location in America. If we have international guests watching, you have to get a license here in this country. And the license is based on hours, and it's different amount of hours for each state. New York, literally, is 1,000 hours. Pressing that nice and smooth. It gives you a chance to relook at your cut too, as you're working through this. And I can look at Isabel's colour. Under the microscope here, Isabel.
Right now.
The question is did Ilario tune in? Did
no.
he tune in and say, I'm watching at home?
He did not.
Oh, shoot. Well, thanks for doing the colour, Ilario. With Isabel.
Yeah, thanks for your help, buddy. Adam Sloan was asking, do you do many gents' cuts with razors?
Yeah, I cut everything with a razor. The razor's a great, you know, tool. It's not a gimmick. I couldn't take this hair and move the... I wouldn't be able to get the hair to move as much as I have. This density of hair without the razor, I'd be thinning it out with a scissor for months. By the time I'd get it perfect with a scissor, it'd need cutting again. So the razor's a brilliant tool. It's not the tool that does the work, it's the human being that's carrying the tool, that's holding the tool. That's what you have to be really aware of, and you just have to learn how to master it. I'm gonna drop my client down a little, bring it down to size, and we're gonna come into the front. Let's work that through. There you go, just follow it through with your comb. Don't let the iron sit in one place. It's gonna take out some of the hair color. So just keep the iron moving at all times. This is a beautiful iron, by the way. We sell these. This is the Isotech KTX450 ceramic. Beautiful iron.
It really is. And the new dryer, I love.
Yeah, it's done amazing. We've sold, you know, hundreds already. It's only been out for like less than 2 months. So again, as a brand, we're really into tools because we need them. And I'm really into, you know, making sure that I work with stuff that I love. So you just take your time to get this done because it makes the difference. Once you get it smoothed out properly, then you can get, it's, you know, you've got to have persistence. The healing oil is a heat protector. So the healing oil is going to protect the hair from the heat. It's also a sunscreen. So, you know, it's a multifunctional product, and it's a glossing spray. So there's a lot of activities that that product does, a lot of things it does. I keep moving the iron right the way through. And pushing the hair around, seeing how it comes. Let's come this side. Work through that, keep that iron moving. So every year we have an event. What's it called, Isabel?
Rojo Expo.
Yeah, have you ever been to one?
I have, but I've never participated, just watched.
You've just watched, yeah?
Yeah.
So, tell us what Arrojo Expo is. Why don't you talk about Arrojo Expo?
Arrojo Expo, I feel like...
I just like the way she started that, didn't she?
Yeah.
Arrojo Expo.
Arrojo Expo. Anyone who's just tuned in?
Yeah.
Arrojo Expo is a celebration of all the Arrojo stylists to come together, collaborate, and make a beautiful collection, share education with other stylists across the US, and yeah, just have a good time and celebrate our industry.
So the last expo you went to was where?
It was at the Brooklyn Bowl, I think.
Yes. Yeah, so right? What happened at the Brooklyn Bowl? Maybe I shouldn't ask that question.
We saw the latest collection that you released, and I think it was called Cosmic Pop, am I right?
Nope, but that's okay. You're doing good.
Okay. I definitely saw that one as well, though, actually.
That was at the nightclub.
Okay, so I've been to two, definitely. But yeah, it's the whole team's there, and people get the tickets and come together for like a few day event. And the final celebration is always kind of the biggest event out of the few days.
Is there hands-on expo?
There's hands-on education.
Right.
It usually follows the day after the collection's launched, I believe.
So I'm going to get right in here, right into the bang-bang. I'm just going to work on smoothing that out just a little. Let's get that, because she does have a little kind of cowlick around here. So just gently just working and beveling under. Come to me. Great. See right in here? It's where the hair kicks. And remember, we didn't take any length off here. But what we did do is we kind of tried to thin it out a little. And you're just important to come through and just try and get a little bit more polish. You know, the nice thing about Brooklyn Live is we do everything. We do the whole thing, so it's nothing like... It's just real time, and you know, we try and show what we can do in an hour and change. You know, so people can learn for all levels. One of the things I'm excited about the most for next year is boot camp. Boot camp is pretty much our four-week intensive. It used to be a program that was in person for 4 weeks, but this is now, we're going to turn it into a year-long program. So it's going to be 16 Sundays based around four different lessons, actually five different lessons. Lesson one's classic haircutting. Lesson two, which will be four Sundays consecutively. Lesson two is going to be all hair color. Isabel's going to teach it.
Me and Lario, hands on.
Lesson three is going to be barbering. And then we also round into lesson three, or course three. We also put in some classic hair styling for, you know, if you want to learn how to do some great updos, which is obviously something that people are scared of a lot. They shy away from that. Some people either love it and some people either shy away from it. So simplifying how you can create great styles in the salon. Our education is based around salon-friendly ideas and techniques. And then the final week, lesson four, is going to be all razor cutting. So that's going to be the 2021. It's going to be a four-week, it's going to be a year-long program, 16 Sundays. So we'll do consecutive Sundays, four at a time. And then we'll take a month off. Information will be going up on Arrojo Pro shortly, which is where we put all of our classes for our schedules. So that's where you can sign up as well. And part of the class, when we're doing virtual classes, we send out a kit. So you have all the tools, the mannequin, the tools to use, so that your education comes prepackaged in a box, and then you learn through Zoom. And me and Carl, Isabel, the team here, we create the magic. So you can start to see the hair changing, yeah?
Looks so cool.
How does it look, Carl?
There you go.
Isabel's going to be asking for a rise now. Yeah, Isabel's going to be asking for a rise. Well, you can stand up. You can stand on this stage anytime, love. If you want to rise, you can just feel free to come here. I'm going to get Carl a. I'm going to get Carl a golden chair as well. He needs a throne. Yeah, not very good. We can dye your scalp if you like.
I could do a good job of that, dyeing the scalp.
Yeah, well, you've already done a good job of that, love. If you've not already noticed, you've already done a good job of that. There it is. Said it here first. Are you still breathing, McKenna?
I'm still here.
You still? What do you think? You've been watching it.
It looks great.
Do you think you like it?
Yeah, I love it.
Good.
I can't wait to touch it.
I can't wait to touch it. I'm going over there. It's too early in the day. Okay, so now we're kind of getting towards it. Now I'm going to pick up the dryer and blow it around a little. And then I'm going to scissor cut it. And then I'm going to style it even more.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm going to style it even more. Just feel how thin it feels. Put your hands in.
Wow.
It's a big change, is it? Can I give you that?
It's lighter.
Don't turn the iron off because I might need it again. Probably will.
Okay.
Let's get my comb in. This helps to work the roots. Makes it a little flatter.
Lisa, I thought it was Alario.
I thought it was Alario.
Looks so good. She's blue, da ba dee da ba da. That was our theme song.
Who did?
Frank Zarcone.
Oh, hey Frank. How are you?
Frank.
Okay, scissor time.
Exciting.
Let's just clean up some little pieces. Let's just now take the edges. And I like to call this kind of just finishing the shape. Just is a great like little cheater's way to just make sure you seal all the ends. Because you can see like in here, it's a little bitty because I didn't really work on the exterior through the back. I just worked on the texture. So I'm happy to keep the shape. I just want to make sure that there's no long stringy pieces. So this just helps to refine what we've already done. So you're not going to see too much because I'm cutting off dust. And you look at your client and you start to see, you know, how she's shaping up.
Getting a lot of love on the media, so fun and edgy.
Good.
Love it.
Say that again.
Love it.
Thanks. He wasn't talking to me. God. Thanks, Isabel. So just point cutting in, just lifting up, looking through. You can see I've got my goggles on, I got my mask on. I'll keep all my Corona in for myself. I'm not a Corona sharer. I want to keep it all for me. See the blonde picture behind me? That was a great razor cut. The blonde on the wall. So the razor creates so much space. So if you lift up the hair, the razor creates so much space. And that space enables the hair to move around a lot more.
So good. Oh my god.
So calm this down. Let's just tighten up right in here.
Big fans over here.
She's got a fan club.
Yeah.
We like that. All right, now let's get in back. Let's go back over to the scissor of a comb. Okay, so let's clip that. Let's get back over to the scissor of a comb. Let's clip that. Keep all that out of the way. Just clean that up. Work it nice and cleanly. My little clips. And we're just gonna tighten up a few little pieces. Right here, a few little areas. A little scissor of a comb right through here. You always comb into the way that the hair grows, which pushes the hair straight out. So the hair grows in many different ways. You go against it. Whichever way it goes, you go the opposite way. Nice and tight, all the way in. Comb the ear back, just get your comb behind. Just tighten that up just a little. Great. Take everything out. We're going to need the iron again in a second, but we're kind of in the final phase now. It's almost done. I haven't touched the outline, so let me spin around and sorry Carl, that was a big one, I know. I moved so fast.
Speed of light.
Just cleaning up the edges right here. We're a L'Oreal salon. We use exclusively L'Oreal color. We also carry Port Riot, which is obviously a brand that is owned by L'Oreal. In my salon, we typically specialize cut or color. And then, you know, nowadays with all this time, we're all experimenting. It's a time for change, especially with, life's not gonna go back to what it was. Life's gonna go forward to what it is. So we have to be ready for that. And that's something that I'm certainly always analyzing and assessing. Let's get the dry conditioner, let's get the dry shampoo. Let's get everything. We're gonna need it. Right, this is what we're gonna do right now. I'm gonna take this off. Let's pull that away. There you go. Let's get that dryer.
There she is. Wow.
Now I'm just having a look at the shape before I start to put more products in. Just having a look at the texture, the shape, the way that the hair goes. Just looking to see. You know, when people show you an inspiration picture, you know, you have a destination, but it doesn't mean it's going to be exactly the same. It's just a destination. Obviously, you know, everybody's hair is different. You got to get those elements in the way that you think is going to work for the client. That for me, thanks. Just put a little bit more healing oil in. It's our glossing spray. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go on top of that with our dry conditioner. Hydrolyzed keratin. It's a dry conditioner. I'm not going to gonna make the hair wet, it's gonna make the hair silkier. Now we go back in. Good job, Izzy. Good job, Ilario.
Thank you.
What do you think, Iz?
I think she looks
did we do it?
Amazing. We did it.
We did it. Go on, you can play with it. Go on. Okay. There you go. Get the bins on. Get the bins on.
Wow. That looks so cool.
You like it?
Yeah, it looks great.
Wow.
It looks so cool.
It's really good.
Good job. Time is it, Cal?
It is.
Good, I got an 11:30 in Soho, so I am bouncing out of here. Big thanks, Isabel. Come and say goodbye to everybody.
Thanks so much, everybody. See you next week.
Don't forget, you can tune in to us every Thursday, Brooklyn Live, and then on Tuesday nights, Nick at 9. Follow me on Instagram. Thanks a lot for your time. Have a happy day and good luck, everyone in California. I'm rooting for you.
Take care, everyone. Thank you.
I know that if I just keep doing the right things religiously, good things will come about. It's not what you do with your hands, it's what you do with your brain. Happy Mondays is back! Down the center back. Look for the center of spine so you know you're in the middle. And let's put in the baseline. Back of the blade. So notice how my hand's not moved. But because the blade's long, pushing the blade in, you get that nice clean edge work. We're living in a new world. What we were trained and what we were taught doesn't exist anymore. I'm telling you, you got to rethink it. It's not going to be what it was. It's got to be what it's going to be. The skill to be a successful hairdresser is to build business.